Gotta find those two miners. Quick. Hello? Can anyone hear me? One of them doesn't look too good.
I think I'm still.
Are you okay?
Who are you?
Corvin sent me. Are you hurt?
My leg. I was a little too close to the blast.
What happened?
We were blasting in the farthest tunnel, but the scaffolding didn't hold. It collapsed. I think it blocked the drainage shaft. Water started flooding the place as quick as I drink ale. I barely managed to drag us here.
So something's keeping the water inside the tunnels.
What are you thinking?
I've got an idea. Are there more explosives?
Are you crazy?
Yeah. She'll still be some up top, but you'll need these fuses.
Are you crazy?
You can't move, and I'm not leaving you. It's not like she can make things worse.
Don't go anywhere. I need to find whatever's blocking that drainage shaft and blow it sky up. Ugh. Refreshing, I guess.
Thank you.
There's the debris blocking the shaft. If I can reach those explosives up on that track, maybe I can blast through the blockage. Maybe I can switch. Spotted. Now to find a way out of this room. We should follow those tracks. See if they lead to the explosives. See where this leads. There's the explosives, up on the track. Just need to get across, somehow. Might be a good idea to drop that ladder. I better shake off this wet. Trick? Oh, guess that got its attention. I'm not giving up. Thank you. Let's go check on those miners.
I thought you blew yourself up.
Are you two okay from here?
I can get this idiot down. Don't you worry. Thanks, kid.
Better let Corvin know his men are all right. I found the two you mentioned. They're safe, but could probably use a hand. Is that everyone?
It is. I tried to think what would have happened if you hadn't shown up.
I knew we were blasting too much, but the man who staked the claim here, Ulvund, he kept pushing and pushing me. I tried to shield my crew from his constant demands every damn day. I should have been stronger.
You were there for your crew when they needed you. That counts for something.
Ulvan can threaten me all he wants. I am not letting my people back into those mines.
Will you be all right?
Yes. I can take it from here. You are owed, Huntress.
Ulvan's name keeps coming up, and it's never good. Sooner or later, someone's gonna have to deal with him.
Thank you, Huntress. I'll see the last two make it out.
Water.
Thank you, Huntress. I'll see the last two make it out.
Could use frost ammo against it. Watchtower at the top of that cliff. Might be a lens up there I can grab for Rena. Looks like the path I broke a long time ago. I'm gonna have to climb. There we go. One of the signal devices. Should be a lens I can grab for Reyna. Got the lens. I can trade it with Reyna the next time I see her. Cauldrons could teach me how to live with these machines.
Ah!
said a Dire would be interested in this. Make an interesting color for my armor. This place has seen better days. I don't think I can get past them. Guess I should leave it for now. Signal device. Should be a lens here. Got it. Another lens for Ola. Find where these machines are made. I might learn how to override them. Carja's signal tower. Might have another lens for Reyna. Okay, almost there. Made it. And there's the signal device. Lens. Reyna will trade for it. I can almost see the entire thing. Thank you. exploring Hogwarts and teach you all of our existence. Find something interesting inside.
The hunting grounds.
Step right up.
This must be the clearing where Conover says he saw the eclipse. What stands? Start as any. Like trouble. Steady. Well, that was fun. Now I need to investigate the clearing that Conover mentioned. Pretty sure this is where Conover killed that guard. Maybe my focus can tell me if there really was a third person here. I see plenty of tracks from the Karja search party. Not helpful. Broken branches. Was someone up here? Faint tracks leading away from barren light. I should be able to follow them with my focus. Let's see where this leads. Maybe Conover wasn't lying after all. Trail. There's too many machines walking around. Maybe I can pick up the tracks once I'm past them. Thank you. easy to follow the trail up ahead now. Blood. A lot of it. Whoever the runner was, this machine must have slashed him. It should be easy to follow the blood trail with my focus. Looks like they're headed for that bridge. Someone set up a lookout down here. Bad view of Baron Light. I'm going to spy on it. Bandages. Looks like the runner tried to treat their wounds before they went on. I should be able to follow their tracks. Where did you go off to? Traylon's here. Must have climbed up to that cave. With that injury, I'll bet he's on his last legs. Get a strong color out of this. This looks like a good place for someone to hide.
Ned! What are we supposed to do now?
We stay on track and make our way out west.
If we give up now, the usurper, we have to find treasure.
In his shadow, we will find treasure.
We don't know Larvik's dead. He hasn't shown at the rendezvous point. So either that fool guard killed him, or he lost his nerve.
We'll just have to blast our way through the gates.
And then what? Rayad was our only link to Vezra, and now he's dead too.
We'll track Vezra if we have to.
But first we have to get past Baron Light. Next change of guard, we go in fast and loud.
Conover was right. I have to stop them before they hurt anyone else.
We may have lost Meridian for now, but it will be ours again someday.
What if Lorovic talked and they know we're coming?
What if I stick this knife down your throat?
Save it for the heretics.
A bard will suffer.
Whoa!
Uh-oh. Time to engage.
Only we'd caught up with Vezra earlier.
No use crying about it now.
Soon we will march in. You really think Vezra has found a new place for us out west?
He knows what he's doing. I'm sure of it.
I'll pay back every Carja that turned code on.
Did you see that too?
All right then.
It better not be a false alarm.
Here! No way! You shouldn't have done that! I'm just starting with you!
I'm sure there's more of them outside. I better be careful. I need this.
So, start looking for her! No! Gomni! You're my prisoner!
And that takes care of that. It sounds like there's more Eclipse beyond the Daunt. If this Rayad was their only link to them, he might have a focus. He could tell me where they are. I'm guessing that's Rayad. The trail must have been his. He bled out trying to get here. I was right. Rayad has a focus.
If you're seeing this, it means you've left the Sundom in search of something to follow. Your journey is almost over. Follow the sun beyond the gates of barren light. And bask in the gloom of future conquest. A new empire awaits.
I'll have to pay this Vezra a visit and crush his new Eclipse Empire before it begins. There's coordinates here, out past Barren Light. Ryad's mask should be enough to prove Conover's innocence. I better take it back to Barren Light. When we fought the Eclipse back in Meridian, I thought that'd be the end of it. Guess I was wrong. What's back here? I think I can climb up this roof. Looks like this camp was abandoned a while ago. I'll save the extra stock for later. Another signal tower. Might be a lens I can grab for Reyna at the top. Is barely holding together. One of the signal devices. Should be a lens I can grab for Reyna. Okay. I think that's the last lens. I should trade. The machine will take a lot of damage from acid.
No one wants to play some Strike? Anyone?
Of Meridian. My wares will help you.
Sir?
Almost ready to go?
There's Erend. That looks like he's had a few.
Look alive, soldier. She's back.
Aloy! Did you find anything?
Eclipse fugitives were camped out on the other side of the forest. And they were getting ready to fight their way through Barrenlight. You just helped save a lot of lives.
Aloy, you know I believe you. But Nozar, he might not be convinced by your words alone.
If he needs proof, show him that. And tell him the man he's got locked up risked his life to expose and eliminate an Eclipse spy.
Huh. I guess you are his savior. Congratulations, soldier. You're a free man. I'll have you out of there before sunfall. I'll make sure this gets to Nozar.
That's it, then. The end of the Eclipse.
Almost. The trespassers you mentioned, the ones who got through Barren Light weeks ago, their leader's dangerous. And he's out there, in the Forbidden West, building up an army.
Sun and Shadow, you're going out there to stop him, aren't you?
I'm gonna try.
I wanna help. I can fight.
I know you can. But you've been through a lot. Once you're out of that cell, you should enjoy your freedom. You've earned it.
Take them out, Savior.
Back doing anything for ya?
Over here!
Guard your arm. Protect and to flex. I await your return.
Is that what I think it is?
Now you've got all your lenses.
My pops would be sad they're tearing down those towers. But he'd be happy these lenses were spared. Many thanks to you, Aloy. Oh, here. What I owe you. Now this has truly been a profitable endeavor for the both of us.
So what are you gonna do next?
I'm taking these back to the claim. Ankle's all better, and I miss the stench of soot in the air.
Let's hope you don't find any more opportunities on your way there.
No promises. Good luck, Aloy.
Ho there! Thanks, Red. Need anything else? You come see me.
Why the Sun King believes we can have peace with... Your impatience does not hasten the Tanakh, Nora.
Only our annoyance.
Well, thanks, but I've waited long enough. It's time to go.
Absolutely not. This embassy depends on diligent adherence to... You shall not!
Keep telling yourself that.
Someone approaching! On a machine!
Open the gates, please.
Do not let her through that gate. That is a direct order.
Sorry, can't do it.
I'm asking nicely.
I don't know what to do.
Hey, Varl.
Hi, Aaron.
What's happening? I know the usual. Aloy wants something. People
Open
try to stand in her way. It's not gonna work.
Oh, that's it. Arrest her.
I'd like to see you try.
Supporting fire?
Yeah, I'm locked and loaded.
Hey, Nozar. You stupid bastard. You think you got the authority to keep that door shut in the savior of Meridian's face? What do you think Sun King Avad is gonna do when he hears what you did? Promote you, huh? Let it through, boys. Saving the world.
Forget something back in Meridian?
Look, Varl.
It doesn't matter. Made it just in time. So this tribe that Murad told us about, the Tanakh, we need their permission to go west?
Yeah, well, I figured it'd be nice if they weren't trying to kill me the whole time.
But this embassy hasn't started yet. We're just gonna barge in?
There's no more politics. No more delays.
Oh, well. Now at least you have some backup.
I guess I do. We'll see how it goes.
That is the line between east and west. Cross it and die.
Hold on now. Let's take it easy.
None may walk this valley until our signal sounds. That was our accord with the Karja.
I'm not Karja. I came here on my own to ask for rite of passage.
But they opened the gate for you, did they not? What is the meaning of this violation?
Why send a child? Do they want to parley or not?
The Karja can't be trusted. This is no...
Forget the Karja. This has nothing to do with them. I need to go west to save lives. Maybe even yours.
The only lives you can save are your own. By turning back. Now.
Hold!
She's telling the truth about one thing. She's not Karja. She's a Nora from the Savage East. And if she seeks to save lives, should we not listen? Let me speak to her. One last favor for a fellow marshal before he's taken away. A fearless, red-headed Nora. You must be the so-called savior of Meridian.
Just Aloy.
I am Unyielding Fashav, once of the Karja High Command, last of the Army of the Setting Sun.
You're Fashav. Avad gave me a message for you, that he waits for you in Meridian, where you belong.
Avad always was polite. Well, now I'm even more curious about you, knowing that you have the confidence of the Sun King. But such an association with the Karja could work against you here, as it often has with me. As you can see, tensions are high. This embassy is a delicate affair. They're about to return me to the Sundom, a gesture that might help soothe painful grievances. And now you arrive, unheralded.
I'm not here to cause trouble. I just need to go west.
So you say. I might be able to help, but I need to know why. Along with some assurance that I won't regret it.
How did you come to be among the Tanakh?
It's quite a story, but not a quick one. Though I suppose neither of us is going anywhere before the embassy begins. You sure you want to hear it?
I guess we have time.
Very well. I marched with Sun King Jiran's raiders when they came west, hoping to moderate their worst impulses. I failed, of course. They committed unspeakable atrocities, stirring the Tanakh into action. When the clans overran our forward encampment at Cinnabar Sands, I stayed behind to help the last stragglers evacuate, and was taken prisoner. I didn't make it easy for my captors, mind you. Then they paid me back in kind on the journey to their capital. I lost so much blood on the way that I was white as a corpse when they threw me before Chief Akaro. I thought I was dead for sure, so I resorted to desperate measures.
So when you met the Tanakh chief, you did something desperate.
I'd kept my ears open as the Tanakh dragged me along, and I heard mutterings about a kind of trial by combat that they revere. So, when they flung me at Akaro's feet, I demanded this rite, called the Kurut, thinking that by winning I could request a boon, my life, or even my freedom. The other Tanakh howled, but Akaro stared them down. And then his gaze fell upon me. Evidently, he appreciated my ingenuity. He allowed me to participate in the Kurut. Little did I know what I was in for.
You said the Kurut is a Tanakh's trial by combat.
Yes. But it is no ordinary trial. It doesn't pit men against each other, at least not directly. Instead, the combatants fight machines in a great arena, and only the strongest survive. Believe me, it is no easy thing to stare down a charging machine while hundreds around you scream for blood.
I know more about that than you might think.
Do you? Well, then you have my respect. Like you, I lived through it to claim my prize. I had hoped for freedom, but well, that wasn't on offer. Only service to the chief.
You wound up serving the Tanakh chief.
The winners of the Kurut must serve the chief as his marshals.
You mentioned that word before. What does it mean?
The word itself refers to a kind of protective spirit from the ancient past. In practice, marshals are Hikaru's roving lawgivers, part magistrate, part judge, part executioner. I won my place among their ranks and served as honor demanded, but many Tanakh still spat on the ground when I walked by. But they did. Until I started forcing them to the ground to grind their faces in it.
I guess that's one way to deal with it.
As you may have noticed, violence is the native tongue of the Tanakh. To survive, one must master it. The truth is, though, the Karja speak it too. More than they should. I can't blame the Tanakh for hating them.
So then, are you still Karja?
Part of me, yes. Always. But there is much to admire about the Tanakh, especially their chief. I've heard stories about what it was like before his reign. Three clans always at war, constantly slitting each other's throats. Hikaru and the Marshals have crafted a delicate peace. And now he looks to the future. Who knows? Maybe that future will include cooperation with the Karja.
The Karja talk about Hikaru as if he's a monster.
The Karja feel compelled to demonize him if only because he swept them from the field. It is true that he is fearsome. When I was first taken before him, I thought he would flay me alive. But he is no bloodthirsty tyrant like the Mad Sun King was. I think that if you were fortunate enough to meet him, as I was, you would find that he only wants the best for his people. I hope you do speak to him. I'm sure you'd interest him. So, that's my story. You're the first Easterner to hear it, but not the last. The Karja need to know what I have learned.
Yeah. The way you talk about the Tanakh is a lot different than how they do. I've never seen markings like those on a Karja before.
The Karja see ink as decoration. For the Tanakh, it is much more. A litany of deeds. A record of vanquished enemies.
Looks like you've vanquished quite a few.
I've fought my share of battles. But I feel that my life, like my markings, is only half complete. This side shows my martial deeds. Before I die, I'd like to see the other half marked with the laurels of peace.
Are you glad to be going back to Meridian?
Oh, I'll admit that I wouldn't mind sleeping in a feather bed or sipping wine from the southern vineyards. But I have another goal in mind. As someone who knows the Tanakh and the Karja, I'm in a unique position to advocate for both. If Sun King Avad is amenable, my hope is to establish a lasting peace.
The Tanakh don't seem that peaceful.
They're not, as a rule. But these are difficult times. Chief Hikaru knows that survival often requires change. Even if that change means putting aside centuries of war.
You asked why I need rite of passage. I'll tell you, but you won't like my answer. 6 months ago, the world almost ended in Meridian. That threat still exists. It's getting worse every day, much worse. Calling down storms, poisoning the water, enraging the machines. The source of it all has gone west, and I'm the only one who can stop it.
I've seen the signs, and I've heard tales of incredible occurrences in Meridian, an army of demons vanquished by a red-haired champion. So I'm inclined to believe you. The burden of your task is written across your face clearer than any mark of mine. I'll grant you this, to serve as proof of your right to travel into Tanakh lands. A task so important, and it's just the two of you. Take it from one who aspires to be a diplomat. Allies are essential. Chief Hikaru knows the West better than anyone. He may be able to help you. He can be intimidating to others, but don't let that deceive you. He is a man of his word.
Maybe. If I need him.
Your choice. You can find him at his palace. Past the mountains to the southwest. Tell him I sent you. and he'll listen to
Look! The Sky Clan's banner!
Marshals. It wasn't easy, but I brought the Sky Clan with me.
And the commander?
No. I could only convince a few. He isn't yet aware we left.
We have banners from all three clans. If there are fewer from the Sky Clan, it can't be helped.
He's right. Sound the horn.
What's going on?
Not all Tanakh can stomach the idea of parley with the Kaja. But enough have come for us to begin.
Then I'll be on my way.
No. The other marshals will not permit it. You wanted safe passage, you have it. After the embassy.
The Kharja have opened the gates.
As the sun rises over a land at war, so too can it set over a land at peace. Today is such...
Hear me, marshals! You who claim to be Tanakh!
Regala, Chief Akaro's biggest mistake. A rival whom he should have killed.
You have forgotten that our people were born in blood. The blood of the Kharja. Instead, you pledge your spears to a chief who conspires with the enemy. Hikaru has betrayed us. The embassy is proof. And all of you marshals are his accomplices. For this, I condemn you to death.
You'll need more than toothless threats to intimidate us. Exile.
Lancers, form up.
They're riding machines.
Where'd they learn to do that?
Sirens.
Vashav! Come with us now, or not at all!
Archers! Light them up!
Get to cover!
Fire at will!
for shot!
Stick to cover! Archers on the ridge!
Thank you.
You! Outlanders! I'll skin you both!
Chief, grant me the honor of this challenge.
Granted.
Shield like that. Better scan it. I can break through a shield if I damage it enough. Gotta get through that shield. I'll grab this now. Subsiding. That shield's not gonna save you. Shield's gone. He's vulnerable. Turn. Come down here and face me!
No! It was an honorable challenge. You've earned your life today. Comrades! Mark this day! Today you have decimated the Marshals! Slaughtered the Karja! So begins our war on Hikaru. Move out!
You gonna make it?
You're going on without me, aren't you? Guess I'm stuck with Aaron. For now.
Come on. I'll take you back to the fort.
It's salvage time, boys.
It can take a hit. I should be able to use it to glide.
Aloy. We're still trying to sort out this mess. Seems like the Tanakh have a civil war in their hands.
That sounds about right. The Marshals weren't expecting Regala to attack.
And the entire Karja delegation was slain. Nozar, Vuadis, Peshav, a massacre. What will you do now?
I have to head west. Hopefully this rite of passage is still good. For what I'm after, I'll cross all of Tanakh's territory if I have to.
Then you have a long road ahead of you. This is only the threshold of the Forbidden West. The Tanakh's true domain lies over the mountains that border Plainsong. Home of the Utaru tribe.
This isn't Tanakh's territory?
All that out there? That's no man's land. It was supposed to be neutral ground, though obviously this Regala ignored that. Her rebels approached from the north, with all those machines they were riding. They must have made camp up that way.
The rebels were riding bristlebacks. And there were bristlebacks in the Daunt.
Are you saying the rebels let them into the Daunt? How would that even be possible?
I don't know. But it's worth looking into.
While you're at it, there were a number of Karja and Osiram who went out there before the gates were shut for the embassy. Maybe you could check in on them. See if they're all right.
I can keep an eye out. Is there a tall neck somewhere nearby?
A tall neck? There's that one, over there, near the Utaru border. But why...
It's hard to explain. It'll help me get the lay of the land.
If you say so. Is there anything else I can tell you before you go?
Do you think the Karja will take action against Regala? Seems like you'd have common ground with the Tanakh.
An expedition of the Karja army into the west could be taken as the start of another invasion. Sun King Avad won't risk it. That said, we can't allow ourselves to be caught unaware by an attack like that again.
It's too bad about Nozar and Vuadis.
At least Nozar went down fighting. As for the Sun Priest, well, no one deserves to go out that way. I'll make sure they're given proper funeral rites. It's the least I can do.
About Peshav.
The man was taken captive by the Tanakh. Survived for years out in the west, only to die just short of the Sundom. It's a cruel end for a good soldier.
There was more he wanted to do. He spoke of advocating for lasting peace between the Karja and Tanakh.
Too late for that now.
What will happen to him?
His body will be carried back to Meridian. As a cousin of the Sun King, he will be accorded official rites and buried with honor. No soldier could ask for more.
Peshav called Regala a rival. Someone that Tanakh's chief should have killed.
Yeah, I reckon he should have. She's obviously a huge threat. Her attack was coordinated and precise. Until you got in her way, that is.
They knew the lay of the land. And they knew Peshav was going to be handed over at the embassy. If the Tanakh weren't expecting her, she must have spent months gathering an army in secret.
They had to have made camp nearby. Somewhere they could lie low until the perfect moment to strike.
You said there were others who went out when the gates were open before. Like who?
Well, in addition to the salvagers that just went through, there were a couple of other parties of Osiram Delvers Even saw two Karja scholars trekking southwest with an awesome crew. Not sure if they're exceptionally brave or just foolhardy.
This area is no man's land.
That it is. The Tanakh used to attack anyone past Baron Light on sight, but after Avad overthrew the Mad Sun King, he reached out to the other tribes to offer reconciliation. The Tanakh agreed to a neutral border zone as part of the peace talks. Karja and Asuram have been striking out into the area ever since.
But now, it seems like Regala and her rebel army have moved in.
Well, I'd never call No Man's Land safe, even in the best of times. The ancient ruins of the southwest are a testament to that. Remnants of some forgotten war.
You mentioned the Utaru tribe. Their lands are between here and the Tanakh further west?
That's right. Plainsong is their home. They're a peaceful bunch, at least compared to the Tanakh. More taken to farming than fighting.
It's hard to imagine a bunch of farmers surviving in the Forbidden West.
Make no mistake, they have a fierceness all their own. When the Karja were pushed back during the Red Raids, their warriors chased ours through the burning fields of Plainsong. The Sun King has made several overtures of peace to them as well, but so far, they've declined.
If they're so peaceful, why decline?
Don't know. I heard they have their own troubles to deal with. Something about a food shortage. You'd think that'd make them open to trade, but no. They just want to be left alone.
You said the Tanakh's lands are far to the west. What can I expect to find between here and there?
Well, as I mentioned, you've got a stretch of wilderness known as No Man's Land, and then new Taru farmlands. Past that are the Tanakh. Their territory is split into three clans. Desert, lowland, and sky.
Right. I saw their banners at the embassy.
The desert clan is closest. Ooh, vicious lot. Where everyone else sees an inhospitable wasteland, they see a challenge to dominate. Somewhere beyond the desert is the tribe's capital and the territories of the other two clans.
You don't sound certain.
I've only heard the stories. During the Red Raids, the Karja army tried to push into Tanakh territory, but the United Clans rose up against them, forced them all the way back to the Daunt.
So no one except the Tanakh really know what's beyond the desert.
Maybe the scholars do, back in Meridian. All those scrolls have to be filled with something, right?
I'd need to be on my way.
Then I wish you luck. The gates will always be open to you should you wish to return. And don't worry about your friends. We'll get them patched up.
I appreciate it.
Sun watch over you, Aloy. I hope you find what you're looking for.
So, this is the Forbidden West. A whole new frontier to explore. The coordinates from the spire should lead to Silence and Hades. And just maybe, a backup of Gaia. It won't be easy out there. The Blight, the storms, Regala's machine riders. But I'll have to push through it all. Find a way to fix the world. Like Elizabeth would. The woman who led the ambush, Regala, had a lot of machines under her command. There's only one other person who has that kind of knowledge. Silence. But what's his angle? Why help to knock the rebels?